long enough, you can love me. I'll be there as yours, you can hold me. Even let you.
Hi everyone, I'm Zana from Luxy Hair, and today I'm going to show you how to create these loose and effortless waves. My hair is naturally straight and fine, and it tends to be more flat, especially at the top of my head. So in this tutorial, I'm going to share you my technique of curling fine hair and share some of my tips to make it look more voluminous. So let's get started. So I have washed and blow dried my hair already this morning. My hair is naturally straight and most of the time I like to wear it down. Because of this reason, I like to switch up my look and create a wavy or a curly hairstyle. I don't know, there's something about curls and waves that just makes me feel more feminine and flirty. Is it just me or you feel the same? I don't know, let me know. Now today I'm going to be creating loose, beachy kind of waves. For this hairstyle, I like to add my Luxy Hair extensions for more volume and length. These are my Dirty Blonde extensions. I love this shade because it matches, I feel it matches so many blonde shades. A lot of my friends have this shade and you can see yourself. It's gonna look even better when it's all mixed in. As for clipping in the extensions, I believe everyone has their own technique. For me, it changes pretty much every time depending on that hairstyle I'm gonna be creating. Since I'm gonna be wearing my hair down, I want to make sure that there's no clip showing at the top of my head. So this time I'll just clip my hair extensions starting from the bottom of my hair and going more towards the middle of my hair. And now I'm just gonna quickly clip in my extensions. Now I'm wearing my 220 gram extensions and now I've clipped one of my 4-clip wefts. To save more space and so that I don't have to clip any more wefts above here, I'm just going to be adding my second 4-clip weft on top of the first 4-clip weft, just to save some space. So now that I've clipped most of the hair extensions in, I'm just gonna play with the front and see where else I can fill in and add more hair. And there it is, my hair with hair extensions. And before we start curling, I'm just gonna brush through all my hair to make sure there are no tangles and it's just nice and easy to curl. So as you can see, before curling my hair, I have actually blended my extensions with hair already. If you want to achieve more tighter curls, more voluminous curls, I would actually suggest to curl your hair first and curl the extensions separately. Because I'm going for a loose wave, effortless kind of look, I have already clipped my hair extensions in and I'm just going to be going from here. So before curling my hair, I'm just going to add some heat protectant. Just to make sure I don't damage my hair. I would also suggest this for everyone who is wearing hair extensions. I mean, as well as protecting your own hair. And now I'm just gonna clip part of my hair away so that it's easier to create the curls. So now I'm grabbing the first section of my hair. As you can see, it's kind of like medium-sized section because, as mentioned, the waves that we're gonna create, they're gonna be loose. By choosing smaller sections, you're gonna create tighter curl, which is not the look I'm going for this time. As you can see, I'm just trying to keep the hair flat when going around the curling wand, and I'm leaving a few inches of hair out, which is going to help create more of a beachy kind of look. Again, not keeping it for too long, and I'm just letting the hair to cool down. Now the next section, I'm going to be curling the opposite way. So I'm going to be switching up the way I'm curling the sections. So one of the sections are going to go, I'm going to be curling away from my face, and the other section I'm going to be curling towards my face. This again is going to help to create more of an effortless look and help add a little bit more volume. Also, this is a great way to help the curls not to stick together. And again, keeping the hair flat on the curling wand. And again, just a few seconds and let the curl cool down. Now I'm switching up the direction again and curling away from my face. Now again, towards the face. Also, just a small tip, if you want your curls to be more defined and more tight, once getting the hair off the curling wand, I like to keep it together so that it cools down while it's curled. In my case, I'm just letting the hair drop so that they create, as you can see, the waves are a lot looser, but I'm just leaving them like as they are now. Now I'm gonna do the same thing on the opposite side, just like I did on this side, switching up the directions of how I curl the sections. Again, clipping away the rest of the hair so that it's easier to curl. Now I'm just adding the rest of the hair. And I'm going to be doing the same thing for the rest of the hair. Okay, now that I've curled most of my hair, this is the fun part where you can perfect your curls. It's especially important for the top part of the hair where you can perfect the look. And I'm just gonna be grabbing a few sections where I want the curl to be a little bit more defined. And I'm just gonna take a smaller section, and this small section is just gonna go over the rest of the hair, and it's just gonna make it more voluminous. For example, this curl turned out to be a little bit flat, so I'm just gonna perk it up a little bit. And the same thing on the other side. Just choose a few sections where you want your hair to be a little bit more wavy and just add it on top. As you can see already, it looks a lot more voluminous and I'm a lot happier with this look. As for the bangs, I'm just gonna create a light curl just to frame my face a little bit more, and so that the shorter hair here at the front blends with the rest of the hair better. But again, I'm just gonna be choosing a smaller section, and I'm gonna start curling very low actually, because most of the curls are, as you can see, the top of my hair is still straight, so you don't want the curl to start too high. So just the tip of the hair and a very light curl. There we go. And the same on this side. Now that I'm done with curling my hair, I'm just gonna quickly run my fingers through the hair to make the curls even more loose and a bit more effortless, and just to make them blend a lot better as well. Also, this helps if your own haircut is blunt, which mine is. I have straight haircuts, so it helps just playing around and just running your fingers through the hair. It helps to blend it better and make it more seamless. So because my hair is naturally straight, it is a lot more flat, I need to add more volume at the top. So what I'm going to be doing is just grabbing a small section of my hair just here at the top, because I just want to frame the face and I just want to add more volume here at the very top of my head. So I clip that away and I'm just gonna tease a small section of my hair, leaving the hair extensions out. You do not want to tease your hair extensions. Before I tease my hair, I'm just gonna add a little bit of hairspray to make the tease hold better. And the same thing for the top section as well. It really depends on how voluminous you want your hair to be. So you can tease even more sections that I'm doing at the moment. I still want it to look natural, just adding that a little bit of volume here at the top. As you can see, I didn't tease my hair that much, but you can already see an effect. And the same thing on the other side. Just gonna clip the hair away. Again, grab a small section of my hair, and you can go as far back as you want. I'm more focusing on the front of my hair. You can also tease without using a hairspray, but because my hair is more flat, I feel that the hairspray helps it hold a little bit better. And I'm also teasing a little bit at the crown of my head. And now that I'm happy with the volume throughout my hair, I'm just gonna finish off this look by adding a little bit more hairspray to make sure that the curls hold all day. And the final step, this is optional, but if you want even more volume for this look, you can tease as tiny sections here. As you can see, I'm just choosing random sections and adding a little bit more volume throughout my hair. Also, I'm focusing on the ends of my hair because it helps to blend my hair with the extensions even better. And the same thing on the other side. And that is it. This is the final look. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments below what is your effortless, loose, beachy kind of wave routine. And if you create this look, make sure to share your photo on Instagram and hashtag Luxy Hair. I would love to see your recreations. Again, thank you so much for watching. Have an awesome day. Bye.